Because we had an understanding before we started, but the next thing you left me behind, and only you were in the spirit and just loving God. At a point, I thought you were seeing heaven because you just left me here and you were communing with the angels. And that's what's so beautiful about you. I mean, did you always know you were going to be a worshiper, or did you just love to sing? What distinguished, at what point did you know that worship was your calling?
Well, as a human being, basically, worship is my calling.
First calling.
But
yeah.
when I got to know, when I got to discover that this is what I'm meant to do, not long ago, not even when I started Ijeoro, not like Ijeoro.
So it was just a coincidence that your songs were mid-tempo. It was slow.
No, it's not a coincidence. The question was when I knew I was going to be a worship leader.
Yes, that's what I'm saying.
And I answered by saying usually, normally, mm-hmm. by default.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know what I mean. You know how it is that people, your song follows a particular trend, you know. Mm-hmm. But all that time you were singing and you were worshiping, but you didn't really know that that was your call.
Well, yes.
So it was just like...
Yes, I just wanted to sing. I just wanted to, as an expressive person, mm-hmm. I just wanted to bring out what I have on my inside and just let my world know that I have this gift. Mm-hmm. Until I got to know that it's more than that for me. Mm-hmm. Although then, it was survival. I was in a survival mode. I wanted to take care of myself, mm-hmm. and I knew this was what I had. Mm-hmm. And I could use what I had to get where I wanted. So... Mm-hmm. I was singing and I was enjoying it. Later, I thought I should go to school. Somebody influenced me to go to school to study music. I said I wanted to study law or English, and he told me, and he said,
You just waste away.
Come on, you know, go and bring your results.
I don't know. I studied law.
No, for us, you know, the way destiny happens for different people is different. You know, if I'd gone to study law, I would just have been a normal, irregular lawyer.
No, but you see, the truth is, if you had actually studied law, you still do this.
Well,
you
know, yes.
I studied law and I still do comedy, so you would just do it in a different way.
Well, I may not have found...
Yes, you probably would not
easily
have.
Easily.
You probably
like
would not
you know,
have
I wouldn't
found,
have
yes.
found
that,
way.
That's so true.
Like that.
That's so,
so
true.
So I got to know later that it's more than just standing before people and showing your skill. Mm-hmm. Mm. You know, it's like God is using you as a tool. Mm. to connect all of us to him. And it's something I'm very, very protective about. It's something I'm very, I don't want to mention it because it makes me afraid that God will use me as, so like I call, I say at seven, like, you know, God will use me as, and people will get connected to
like
him.
Like a ladder to him, yes. Well, my name is The Precious Bosse, and I'm a comedian, entertainer, and I am hanging with my sister Shola Alizis.
And I'm so excited to hang out with her.
I'm more excited. You know, I was saying before we got on that one of the things I noticed about you is that it's difficult for people to sing along with you. One try. To sing along with you, you know, like most worship leaders have like maybe one chorus and then we all sing it and sing it and sing it. We even sing it better than the person that wrote it. There's something about the way you sing. I've noticed that if I see you at a concert on Monday and I see you at another concert on Friday and I see you at another concert on Sunday and you sing the same songs, oh, the same arrangement, it's always different. It's always different. There's always that I think you're the kind of person that performs on the in comedy we call it spontaneity. I think your worship is spontaneous. I think it's the environment or the crowd or the mood. I don't know what it was, but how does that work with you?
Well, I think I'll answer this question in a nutshell before. By default, I worship God in everything I do, even when I'm not singing. And I hope we know that worship is not just when we're singing.
Of course.
You know, I try as much as possible to not to make, not to just glamorize my gift. No, glamour is good. Showbiz is fantastic. Yeah. But we have to know why. I got to discover why I was given this gift. Yes, you'll be famous, you'll be popular, you'll have money, but after all, like we say, when then? You know,
at the end of
I got to know that it is more serious than just appearing before people. Normally, me, I don't like appearing before people. I don't like coming on stage and everybody is. I like just to be somewhere
just
and sit down
quietly.
But God knows why He has done it this way. And every time I try to connect to the core of why I have these gifts, especially when I am doing worship. If I'm in a social event, if I'm doing a wedding or a birthday, it will be different.
Well, I don't know about that though, because I've seen you performing, and 1 minute we're all dancing, and we're all dancing, and the next minute we're on our knees. I've seen you do that so many times. I mean, we're like dancing, we're feeling like it's a groovy song, and then you just start ministering in the middle, and you just start saying some specific things, and you know, the atmosphere just changes. I think I always tell people who I know in the industry that if you want to sing and you're sharing stage with Shola, sing before her. Because once she sings, after her, it just changes. The tone changes, and if that person does not know how to continue that tempo, if that person is we seem to think that praise is fast and worship is slow. So let me just explain it that way, you know. So if that person is like a praiser, it's going to take a while to catch up. Because most of the time, when you sing, I leave the hall when you're done, because I don't want to cut that connection. So when you finish singing, I remember one time I can't remember where it was. Somebody, you finished singing and the person got on stage and the person was going, "Praise the Lord!" And I wanted to pity the person, like, you know, what's wrong with you? This is not why we are here. The mood has changed, the atmosphere has changed, everything has changed at that point. So I see you as somebody that spends a lot of time in your closet. And so I'm wondering, if you were to write a song like Eji Ohuro now, a love song now that you are so in the spirit, how will you draw on that inspiration?
Well,
because
well,
I can't even imagine you singing anything else but worship. But let's just look at it.
Well, I'm a singer. Naturally, I'm a singer. And I try to give as I receive. Mm. As the songs come to me, mm. The mistake we make is that we put people in boxes. Mm-hmm. That this is who she is. That's. Mm. I tell people, there was a time some people used to call, people still call me a Joro, and I don't like it. Yeah. I don't like being defined by a song. And they say, some people see me and say, ah, a Joro, but you're for me. And I answer, I smile, but I don't like it because I am not defined by a piece of art. Mm. I'm not.
Okay, I know we are still live, so it's fine. We have like, since we are live, it's fine. You guys just imagine what we look like, because I know you cannot see us now. but then while we are waiting for the light to come on, can you read any of the messages on there on our live? And maybe like there's a question or something.
No, there are no questions. We just have stuff like. Love you, my evangelist, my best gospel singer, yeah. My sister boss, you're too much. And of course, we are listening to an advert on Radio Lagos, and it was your song, Ejewuro, rolling on air. Ooh. I wanted to post something on IG, and look, we saw you live. Amazing.
Okay, now we have light back, and we're back, and I'm still the precious boss, and this is still Shola and the same. You know, it's funny, a couple of years ago, I like to say a couple of years now, because Tope Idowu and I went to UN together. You know, I studied theater arts, if I studied law. And I remember when he did that movie, and there was so much drama in the industry then. Why would he use an unknown name? An unknown name for his soundtrack. I mean, what's wrong with this guy? And Tope kept saying, I don't know, but me, I've heard this girl. I know what I want. I know what I want in the background of this. And people are like, but the song is not really, movie is not really Yoruba, it's not really, you know. And there you were. I mean, it was the most amazing discovery when you are, in quotes, a nobody.
Yes.
And then somebody gives you such a huge platform. I think that song was a major foundation of the success of that movie. How was that drastic change for you?
Well, nobody knew it was going to be like that.
Yeah.
Nobody knew it was going to be. They just, I don't know. It's when destiny wants to happen, something just, you know, God uses the foolish things of this world to come. Whatever is worth doing at all is worth doing very well. Destiny will happen to you. Things, doors will open. You don't have to.
In fact, now we have to take a break. Because you see, you have mentioned that word like 3 or 4 times, and that song has been coming into my spirit, and we just have to do that song together. But, you know, people keep saying it's destiny helper. I don't think destiny
changer.
I don't think God is a destiny changer. Because the destiny he gave us when he created us in his first place was a good one.
Exactly.
It is the issues of this life,
yes,
that changed it.
Exactly.
So me, I feel the devil is the one changing destinies.
Yeah.
God is the destiny helper. Mm. So I think we should just, people online, just worship God with us as we take this song. Let's just sing Destiny Helper.
Is it, what do we sing?
Destiny Helper.
Thank you.
And I pray for those of you following and enjoying this with us that your destiny will be helped by Amen. God today in Jesus' name. Amen. Only God can help your destiny. I mean, imagine somebody, nobody knows her. She didn't even know she could sing that well, I'm sure. And somebody says, come, let's try it. And that was the beginning. And it has been glory to glory to glory since then. That's totally amazing. I think your testimony inspires me to, I'm serious, to just lean on God and just trust God completely.
That's what we need to do. It wasn't like I wasn't singing before it. I'd always been a backup singer before then.
Yes.
I worked with Auntie Sarah Moye. I worked with Uncle Benga Dipoy. I'm forgetting all those. I'm forgetting now.
You acted Benga Dipoy. You were coming, you were singing all those.
Yes, now. I worked with. Yes. I can't remember. I worked with Miss Dipoy Dipoy. I worked with Uncle Benga Ifele.
So, in short, what you're saying now is that preparation met with opportunity.
Exactly.
So it wasn't like you had the gift and you were sitting and you were just
waiting. Everywhere I found myself, I was known for me. That's what they used to say.
You
know, I don't know how to say
that. I know there's no name, but I will say it for you. She said, go and call Shola, she will kill the song for you. She will sing the song to death.
You know, and even in church, everywhere I found myself, I wanted to be useful. I wanted to do something. I found, I was born a Muslim, even as a Muslim girl. I was singing in all the Asalatu. I found myself in a C&S church, of course. Fantastic.
Perfect for you. Because they sing a lot.
Later, by myself, I went to Sele. Because I
those
wanted to
can
sing.
Even dance and sing.
Because I wanted to sing, guys. You know, everywhere I found myself. Everywhere I found myself, and everywhere I find myself, you know, because of the brand now.
Brand,
you say everywhere I find. In fact, I'll tell people in my church that I'm available if you want to use me. Except, okay, maybe I've been booked or something. But anytime I'm available. Call me to do anything you want me to do, because I know the God of the gift. I'm not really. The gift does not even define me.
It reminds me of one song like that we used to sing when I was in the choir. No, I'm available to you. My will I give to you. I'll do what you say to use me, Lord, to show someone the way and enable me to say, Lord, I'm available to you. But you know, it's a very old song.
That's the way our hearts should always be. You don't have to be a singer. Don't have to only be a singer. As a comedian, as a dancer, as somebody that can hold the camera in church, as somebody who can sweep, just show. Just not like the way it is nowadays for young people, where you just want to go to church to have a platform. Because I can sing, so if I go to KICC, if I go to House of
Rock, I'm going to Blue.
When we were moving to Lagos, and I was asking around what church we could attend, somebody actually told me that there's a church, elevation church, that you should go there. They do a worship event. I said no,
that's not the point.
I'm not going there because so that they will be inviting me to them. And funny enough, that's the church we attend now.
Yeah,
I just went to the church. Pastor Wale Adenuga was invited to the church, and I wanted to surprise Pastor Wale. He's my friend. I wanted to surprise him that now I'm in Lagos.
Yes,
you will see me. So I went. And I was just blown away with the ambience, with the music and the word. And we knew, okay, this is a place where we could grow. And we started going to church. So if they wanted me to do something, I'll do. If they don't want me to do, I'll be.
Yes.
And serve God. You know, so it's by default, by everything we do regularly, when it is sweet, when it is not sweet. Well, it is not like after a Jowuro, so I just everything else that I'm becoming.
Yeah, it's going to be easy.
You know, sometimes you cry, sometimes you laugh. That's the way life is. Although, what I thought was, after a Jowuro,
right now.
But no, not that like
it's going to be smoother now.
All the suffering in my life.
Yes, now. We all feel like that.
No, has ended, but I got to know that yeah, you go. Mm-hmm. There's another step that mm-hmm. you have to, you know. So, but everything that we do has to point towards the fact that I love you, Lord. Anything, whether you slay me mm-hmm. or whatever,
yes,
I belong to you.
Yeah.
Whatever happens to me, whether that money that is,
you know, it's one of the problems I'm having with the present day church. Okay, and we're not going into church, but it's one of the problems I'm having. Now we are so packaged.
Yeah.
You know, because when I first gave my life to Christ, I mean, in those days of UI, you wear white lace and you're rolling on the floor and you don't care who is looking. And now you are in church, the worship is good, you are crying and people are looking at you as if you committed a sin.
As if you have a problem.
As if you have a problem, that's why you are crying. Or as if you are trying to ask God for... then God help you, they know something about you.
Yeah, exactly.
Maybe they know that you are not married or they know that you are trusting God for a child. Or immediately you just start crying like this. You say, oh my shield. We even see some people sending you messages. Inside Doris said that don't worry, my sister did not do it.
There was a day I was crying in church and someone just said to me, look, let's go and let's go. I looked at her like,
you don't get it.
You don't even know why I'm doing what I'm doing. You know?
You don't get it because sometimes the presence of God can be so overwhelming. There's no other way to express yourself but to cry.
Exactly.
It's not like you are in sin. It's not like you are walking in disobedience. You just can't comprehend this manner of love.
Sometimes I have a word that I receive that mean corinthian morning in this song. Sometimes my spirit sings a song, but my mind cannot
comprehend it. Yes,
so I cannot comprehend. So I can't put it into words. Mm. So when I'm in such a mood and somebody sees me, maybe I cry at that point, or I just decide to sit on the floor at that point, and somebody says, so maybe because she wants something from God, that's why. No. Sometimes I just worship God not because he puts food on my table, not because
it's God.
Just because I am supposed to worship
just because
him.
He's God. That in itself is you know, and then you know there's this thing we call the sacrifice of praise. People sometimes think that sacrifice of praise has to do with the fact that you need something from God. I mean, no, sacrifice has to do with the fact that you don't feel like it. Because, you know, especially when we're in the public eye, people think that we're always happy, really. People think that our life is always rosy, we're always driving good cars, and they don't know, you know.
You know what I know about that? Everybody has something or the other. Like you said, the destiny that God gave us, his mind towards us is good. But between that place and this place,
the middle. Between the up and the down.
Yes. Something has happened that's more than meets the eye.
Yes.
That we can't explain.
I always tell Auntie Debbie, at the point that, in quotes, my destiny was challenged, I would not say was trampled upon, and my destiny was derailed. At the very point, I can tell you the exact point that it started. You understand? And I think most of the time when these things happen, we know.
Yeah.
But we have watched so many African magic, we have convinced ourselves that God cannot help us,
and we have had some eroded belief.
Yes.
That when you are in this world, there won't be any tribulation.
There won't be any tribulation.
Contrary to
no, we have the belief that once you become born again,
exactly,
tribulation will
disappear. That's the word I was looking for. That when I tell young people, when I'm on a platform and I'm supposed to do altar call in my own way, I tell them, don't believe that because I'm not calling you to become born again so that you can have money. I'm not calling you to become born again so that
you can hammer, blow. Because that's the message they gave us.
Yes.
Come out. Give your life to Christ so that your life can be better. So
your life will be better spiritually. It will now
give you the key.
Exactly.
To the kingdoms. Yes.
So because we thought that's why we have so many suicide cases. Because when I become born again, I go to church. When I give 100,000, God will give me 10 million.
God is a kalukalu. But I always tell people to the wayo man, God is a wayo God.
And so when you cannot
swipe.
When that is not happening, we get disappointed. And we think, and what we're saying was that people think people like us show up on television. We are very, very perfect.
Our life is together.
And I was saying that what might two of us do was some things had happened before we were born.
Yes.
Some things happened right now. Some things are still happening. You know, that are contributing to some robbing or robbery, you know, from the darkness. You know, and we have to fight. Every time we have to
it's
fight.
It's a warfare.
Every time, every single time when I'm playing, when I'm conscious of the fact that they should alone, but you know, got it
back.
So I am not going to be trivial. Even when I'm joking, when you are, for instance, when I see that you're in an event I'm going to, I'm looking forward to laugh. And but as I'm
does
laughing,
not change the, yes.
I am conscious that this what I'm doing here, I am fighting you. It may not be physical fight. It's not like I don't get happy. Maybe I'm wearing makeup now.
Yes,
I'm wearing chocolate now.
Yes.
It's not like I don't get happy. But I am always conscious of the fact that something wants to work against my destiny. This thing that God has given me, something wants to work. And that is, I think that is the way. I'm not going to say because some people will say because
you.
Bible says I know the Bible says that, but the Bible says we should work out our own salvation with fear and trembling.
Work. It's a work.
And the Bible says, I remember it in Yoruba, you know,
yes.
So I know that, and I'm not expecting Idamu, but I know life is about Idamu.
Yes.
Because if life was not about Idamu, when I wanted to give birth to my son, it should just come without the baby.
Yes, so you should not.
It should just come.
Just sleep and wake up and see the baby.
Yes, now abang mama jema zoro abe. You know things like that. It should just. But in this world, when I put something in the ground, it would take a while. That thing is fighting in the ground to sprout. It will take a while. So I know, I have an understanding that, okay, like you said, when your destiny was going to be tampered
challenged,
you knew.
Yes.
Because you are conscious.
Yes.
Because you are, even as a comedian, people will think that she's not serious. All those people, they are just making people laugh. What do they know? They're just making people laugh. You knew because of the relationship you have always had with the Holy Spirit.
Yeah. You know, then, you would say I'm going back, but we have to worship again because this is just about worship. And every time you keep mentioning that word destiny, I keep coming up with another song. And the song came to me right now.
I hope I will know it.
I can assure you,
able to
this one is very simple. This one is very common.
Because my piano play is very
don't lost. Worry, once you don't remember the piano, the key to play is pause. Then we'll continue again. But we just want to love God. And I'm sure that somebody somewhere is watching and just join us and just enjoy God.
Well, I will lift up my eyes to the hills. Cometh, cometh my help.
I can't play to eat.
My help cometh from the Lord. The Lord which made heaven and earth.
My favorite part.
He said, he will not suffer my foot to be moved. The Lord which keepeth me, he will not slumber nor sleep. For the Lord is my keeper, the Lord is my shield. Upon my right hand, upon thy right hand. Shall not smite me by day, nor the moon by night. He shall preserve my soul, even forevermore.
Thank you for help with thank you for helping. We thank you for helping our destiny, our vision, our tomorrow. We just give you praise, eternal King of glory. We celebrate your glory in our lives. We celebrate your grace. We celebrate your calling. We celebrate your ministry. Thank you, Jesus, for the help that only you can give, the help that only you can send. Thank you for 2018, the year that you will help us. Thank you, Lord. We give you praise. We worship you and we adore you. Blessed be your holy name, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
And something came to my heart as I was singing this song. We could have people watching us or that would watch this lesson and they're looking to God for help. And help is nowhere to be found right now. My brother, my sister, I identify with you. I know sometimes everything is just dry. And you know, sometimes I ask, but you called me, you gave me this gift. I am supposed to prosper with my gift. So what is happening? I'm not saying I'm poor. I'm not poor. But I need more. I want more.
Yes, we all do.
I want more. I'm not looking for pity. I'm looking for favor. I want more. So I'm just trying to let you know that you are not the first. Neither will you be the last. There is a time and season for everything. Before I stumbled, can I use that word, stumbled? But before I, let me...
Stepped in.
Yeah, into a Jehovah that like makes people call me a star. Not a star yet. I'm still on me. Watch out for me. You know, before I step into that territory, that you're looking at, what's in the go? Don't take, okay, shame me.
It's after.
You know, different things that I've experienced. And I was always telling God, I shall know. We shall serve you. As much as I knew that, I didn't know much of God that I know now. I'm still knowing more. But then I was telling God, as the little knowledge I had of him, I was saying, I know. Musha. God told Danny, you will reward me. You will make me great. You will help me. And everywhere I found myself, I was being helpful. And there we were. We got there. And here we are now. So I'm just trying to tell you that your time is coming.
Amen.
Your help. As long as you look to this God that I know, I am telling you what I know. I'm not telling you what I read or what my pastor told me. I am telling you what I've experienced, what I am experiencing. God is faithful.
Yes.
Osibo se le je.
Yoruba ni ni abi akoso bo ti won gori.
Bo se ogori. God is
as long. I love Yoruba language.
Yes, you are doing his will and walking in. Yes, true. Nobody can be perfect, but try. For easy now in 21st century,
it's
without the internet and all
this thing,
and all the cosmetic nature
everything,
of the church now.
Yes.
Go easy. But let me tell you. God always comes through.
Amen. Amen. But you know, I know you're married now. And
yes,
you have a child?
I have three.
Three, yeah. So I mean, can you imagine? She has three kids. Look at this abuela. These are eight children. Three children and she's still maintaining this slim body.
Me
and,
that there was
and,
a time.
And me, I'm running, jogging,
you know, let me tell you something.
Sacrificing
let
everything.
There was a time I was ready to be big. Especially this area. This
then,
my area.
Earlier in the cake, you might play the role. When you people finish praying to be big. Then you now gain 2 kg, you now run to the gym. You know. But how has managing, you know, a career in music, because entertainment is not like specific like everybody else, 9 to 5, you know, and we can't even plan our income. This month can be very good, next month cannot be good. So so you can't even tell your husband, wait, on the man worry, if you're 100k, me mom won't know, project affection by end of the month. There's no assurance. How has it been to merging, being married, being a mother, a family woman, and how have you been able to keep your family out of the limelight? I mean, that I really love, you know, you have worked very hard to keep you. I mean, I can sit beside your husband and be gossiping about you and I would not know. You know, how has that been?
I don't know. I just live. I'm just myself. Like I said, I don't like being known. It's not like I hate it though. I'm not saying I don't like you know what I mean.
You like it's to not, keep that.
I like to be on my own. Mm. It's not like I go out, I get somewhere and some people say, hey, there's something happening.
I don't understand.
Maybe I'm not, well, of course, I'm not wearing it and I just write my name.
Trust me, they say that to me too.
And they say, hey, there's something.
I didn't know. Oh, no, you know the one I hate most? When you're not nice to me, and then you now find out who I am, and then you start becoming nice, and I'm like, yeah, no, I'm first a human being. Just be nice to me because I'm a human being.
Exactly. So it's not something I set out to do. Like, I want to put myself in the glare of the public. It's not easy to be in some hatred. Some animosity can just fly.
Some people just don't like you because it is you. Some people don't like you because they feel you have their life.
Exactly. So it's not something I couldn't have made the mistake of, or I can't make the mistake of just blowing everything by myself.
It first starts with marrying the right man, though.
Thank God for that.
Because I mean, if he didn't understand your vision.
Because I had been there, he met me a singer.
My sister, leave that information. Do you know how many people met themselves as?
Yes,
you know, it just has to do with seeing you where you are going.
You know, I've always, and I don't want to say this so that it won't be like sounding like I prayed. There were many guys on my path when I was single, and I deliberately chose my husband because I would look at this one. But look, where is he headed towards? What? Who is he? What is he doing? This one, what before I chose that guy that I had an idea.
You can connect. Nobody's perfect, but I mean, you can connect.
I had an idea of the kind of life he wanted to be, the kind of person he wanted to be, the kind of idea he had about God's idea for him.
You know me, I'm always saying that to people. You know, when I meet men and they're talking to me, and my pastor said, TDJ said, Justin said, my pastor said, and I'm like, what did you say?
Yes.
What are you saying? Because I need to know what you are saying. Exactly. I can't comprehend you fishing in other people's interpretation of the word. What are you saying? Because if you're interpreting based on what somebody else is saying, then that means that I'm talking to TDJ and not you. I need to know what you are saying.
Exactly. Yes. So I had an idea of then there were guys around me that wanted to marry me because I was a singer. And they thought it would help life. But I didn't even connect with them anyway. Like you said, that helped or helps a lot. And me, my circle is very small. It's only where you are, jala listening.
No, we all can do that thing. When I tell people that I can be in my house for like a whole month, and nobody
and it can be it can be disadvantage or something. Oh, yes. I was sick recently.
I was hospitalized for 6 months. Nobody even noticed there was
anything. Mr. Bani has to work. My children are small. My sister Kemi that came to stay with me, she had to go back to her husband's house. My cousin that came from Ibadan, Big Bomi, she had to go back to
you. Now wonder what
happened. And I was crying.
And you cannot blame anybody now because
you said you want yourself to.
And when I finally got well, and people were like, you didn't tell us. I said, I didn't know that sickness is not wedding invitation. Because do you call people to say hello? Was sick? You know, if you know I'm sick because you are looking for me and you can't find me.
Nobody to go and buy it for me. I ordered where I live. It's very far. Before the bus is like 4 hours later.
It's cold.
And I started crying. God, why now? Who will take care of me?
You want your circle to be small. God reminded you how small you wanted your circle to be. So maybe you should make it a bit bigger. You know, it's worse for people like me because I am in a profession that, in quotes, makes us look like we're happy and we're all bubbling and everything. So people always feel that, I'm the life of the party. I sometimes I'm confused about myself as well because when I'm in public, I am that. But when I'm alone, I just want to protect that being alone, you know? So I don't want to go out unless I have to go out.
I think that's the way it should be. To maintain your sanity, to live a good life. To live a good life. If you look at some artists in the past of old, what killed them was dancing to the tune of the society.
Now that you have talked about the artist of old, brings me back to where I was coming from, because now we have left music and we're talking about marriage, so let's go back again. I liked that because I needed to say that because people seem to think that when you're in entertainment industry you don't have any ambition to have a good home. but so I needed to say that. But now we are talking about music. I have noticed, I don't know about other people, every time I need to have a connection with the Holy Spirit, every time I'm going through a storm and I just know that there's a silence, you know, that, you know, when there's just a silence,
yeah,
you
can't
know,
hear anything,
yes, you can't hear anything, you know, and I found out that nothing works for the old songs. So I go for the Hosanna Integrity, the Bob Fitts and Maranatha singers, the all the very old ones, because somehow I can connect the words. The Bible says that the words I speak to you, they are spirit and they are life. I think that there's too much activity in the ones we are singing now. Everything is just I can't.
We have the thing. What I think, I'm not judging anybody. Every piece of art is unique. I'm not judging anybody. Whether you want to sing flute, you want to sing
It's fine.
You want to do hip hop.
You will appeal to somebody, Sha.
Yeah. But I'm saying that. We have ambition, but we have agenda with the songs we sing.
Exactly.
Like, let me put these lines together. When I believe my heat come, I'm on my line. Marketers had come to me in the past and told me I should do this and this.
How have you been able to maintain that this is what God told me, despite the pressure of commercializing your music?
You know,
because I know that if you commercialize your music, you will sell. There is a way you will sing it and we will rock it. But you have kept to that pattern.
You know something we don't understand? I said...
If you are not saying it, we won't be here now.
That's what we don't
understand. We won't even be having this discussion if you are not saying it.
That's what we don't understand. But the way you say...
Meanwhile, I don't understand. I'm not afraid to interrupt this thing. Why is my own live video not showing? Because I have noticed that you have not been using it and it's worrying me.
Where is the phone now?
It's worrying me.
It's not connecting to you.
It has to connect. Or we look for my second phone, but let us connect. No, take it out of Wi-Fi. Leave it to you. The same thing, Abby. Then you can use my second phone. Just use my second phone.
Where's the second one?
It's somewhere there. It's the big one. I didn't give you that one because it's heavy.
It is heavy.
No, but we can remove the case. I know that you guys know that this is live at the end.
Yes,
but
that's
is
real life.
That's
the way life is.
Even in
the studio.
Even in real life.
That's the way life is. Things happen. Nepa takes life.
You know?
It's not everywhere. Nepa does not take life everywhere.
It's connected. Don't connect to Wi-Fi at all.
Okay.
Just use my own data.
Adema, all right.
Yes, very soon.
Yes.
Very soon.
Adema, all right. Yes.
But so I'll be connected.
This is the kind of house I want to have. To have piano inside my house. Whether I'm singing on key or off key,
it's a joyful noise.
Joyful noise. Are we back now?
Okay. Well, you are always live on Facebook.
Okay.
On the Great Worship platform.
Facebook people should just be enjoying us and the other people on Shola Addison's page, you now know that I exist and follow me, so it's okay. God is joining it.
So we're talking about, I'm not saying we should not talk about vision. I'm very ambitious. Hey, if you know the kind of car I want to drive.
You know me, when people ask me, when I was growing up, they say, what do you want to become? I have never remembered saying anything else. They say, what do you want to become when you grow? Rich and famous. I don't know whether I want to be doctor or lawyer, but what do you want to be?
I want to
rich
have a
and
lot
famous,
of
I
money.
Clear.
So I have ambition. It's not like I don't have ambition. What I'm saying, if you call yourself...
If you call yourself a gospel musician.
You know, myself, I didn't come out to call myself a gospel. It is what my word perceived
of you.
Or perceived or perceives of me that make them call me. I don't have to put a placard on my head and say, Jesus, 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 God, 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 God. It is what you, by your fruit.
It be known.
We should understand that God that can stop the Ebi.
Yes.
The God that can stop the poverty is whom we should strive to understand first.
We should learn to spend time
with him.
You know, I keep telling people.
His mind, his ways.
I keep telling people that there are celebrities that you think you know, but you don't know. There are celebrities that go to camp every Friday night.
Yes, now.
Nobody is there.
Yes.
It's just them and God.
Yes.
So the spirit controls the physical.
Exactly.
And it is what we tap into in the spirit realm. You know, people have said to me, you should say your jokes like this. You should do it like this. Mm-hmm. You should do this kind of show. And I'm like, I need money. But that is not where God is sending
you. Exactly. So that's what I'm
and saying. You will not even know some of the offers have been made in my life. That I know that if I had accepted them,
yes,
I know where I would be. Exactly. But then that is not the express instruction of God. And while you feel that you are not attaining because you're not doing that thing, it does not mean that you are not attaining, if you know what I mean. Like, I always tell people, because they did not see us in first class, they did not see us in economy, they think we didn't fly. They don't know that we are sitting in business class. So sometimes people feel that they can define your success.
Exactly.
They're like, they did what's the name of that concert? They did experience. You are not there. That they have defined you. And because you are not there, you are not successful. They don't know whether you are in Houston, Texas,
exactly,
on that same day.
Exactly.
Yes.
Exactly. And, you know, so I'm not saying we should do this to be ambitious, but if you say you are doing gospel, you have to do gospel.
Mm-hmm. If you even say you are doing gospel, you have to prove that you are doing gospel. Because that gospel will be tested.
You have to do it. Mm-hmm. Especially now, it is very easy now to sing. You know, there was a time, when I started out, because the Jowuro was not sounding in particular way.
To interrupt too. Your fans are going crazy on Facebook. They want you to sing something. They didn't tune in when you first started. And I think, is it a Jowuro?
They should send prophet's offering.
Okay. Okay, so we're going to go
do
into
singing.
Benga they want to sing. Because Benga will come and
I will take over from Benga.
Benga will play because
so that people will not know that it's a long time. I was a piano minor in school, but it's a long
if you were piano major, trust me, it is Nigeria and it is social media. Some people have no other work but to criticize you. So even if you do it very well, they will look for something to complain about. So let's not worry. Well, I said it was going to be an informal recording, so we just look for. Can we have a bench or something? Or
give her that chair.
So what song are we singing? Is that Benga?
Benga,
which of my songs do you know? You are Lakowe.
It is Shola. Do freestyle. Just do freestyle. Shola will
Let's just do worship.
She has been singing since what did they? No, we just joined. Everybody in the studio, do not sing.
Thank you.
Christmas.